Good morning, students. Just take an example, 4 divided by 1. I am given, let us say, 4 pencils. How many 1s are there here? There is 1 1, 2 1s, 3 1s and 4 1s. There are 4 1s out of the 4 divided by 1 is 4. Let us say, 4 divided by 2, let us say. I am given 4 pencils. How many 2 combinations are there? 1, 2 combination, 2, 2 combinations. 1, 2, therefore 4 divided by 2 is equal to 2. Here I am trying to look out how many 1s are there in 4. How many 2s are there in 4? Similarly, 4 divided by 4. How many 4s are there in 4? Etc. We'll look through normally. Similarly, if I am going to think about 1 upon 1 by 2, I mean to say how many halls are there? Practically speaking, if you know mathematically this 2 goes up, you normally say how many 1/3 are there in 1 is equal to 3. How many 1/4 are there in 1? Obviously, it is 4. This is anybody knows quickly. Therefore, if you look at the denominator here, if it is of the form 1 by n, I keep on reducing the denominator. If I keep on reducing the denominator here in the fraction 1 by n, when I keep on reducing the denominator of the fraction 1 by n, the whole fraction keeps on increasing. Here 1 by 1 by 2 is 2, 1 by 1 by 3 is 3, 1 by 1 by 4 is 4, etc. Therefore, when I think about the denominator n is as close as possible to 0, my 1 by n will be a quantity which is nearer to infinity. This is mathematically written as limit n tends to 0 of 1 by n is equal to infinity. Or we can even say it is not defined either way. This can be even explained by using ordinary paper folding technique. Just take an A4 sheet of paper to represent number 1. Okay, you just fold it equally and unfold. I will get 2 halls. Then I am supposed to think over it. How many halls are there? I already told you. How many halls are there? There are 2. Okay, let me just think about, there are, I am making it 3 equal parts. How many 1/3 are there? Let us say there are 3 1/3. Okay, I'll make it into 4 equal parts. Okay, how many 1/4 are there? How many 1/4 are there? There are 4 1/4, etc. Therefore, if I am going to think about denominator is a quantity nearer and nearer to 0. How many such quantities are there you can think about? When n is a quantity nearer to 0, the size of the paper will be as small as possible, which you may not be looked through with normal eyes. You have to look through only through a microscope. And how many such bits of papers will be there? Infinitely many. We may not be able to even count. Therefore, this automatically explains you that limit n tends to infinity of 1 by n is equal to infinity. I repeat, if you want, how many halls are there here? 1, 2. There are 2. How many 1/3 are there? 3. How many 1/4 are here? 4. And so on. Therefore, if I think about my n to be nearer and nearer to 0 in the fraction 1 by n, I am supposed to think about the size of the paper. Size of the paper will be as small as possible, which we may not be able to look through normal eyes, which we have to look through only through a microscope. How many such pieces will be there? It will be infinitely many. Small bits of paper, which are as many as possible, may not be able to count at all. Therefore, we come to the conclusion, limit n tends to 0 of 1 by n is equal to infinity. Therefore, this kind of explanation through paper folding technique makes your job easier to understand such limiting values. Thank you very much.